Michael McKillican, check your home before you list.
Now, mold forms because in the wintertime, your house is heated with warm air, okay. And that warm air is swollen with moisture.
Yep.
Now, that warm, moist air comes up through the attic floor and it gets into the cold attic.
All right.
Now, it still has a lot of moisture in it. Now, the underside of your roof sheathing is really cold. When that warm, moist air hits that cold sheathing, it condenses and frost will form.
And I've seen that. I've seen it on the underside of the roof and I've seen it on the nails.
Right. And so now, when the plywood is wet and when conditions are right, the mold will start to grow. But our job today is to get rid of the existing mold. To do that, I brought in a special crew.
Sounds good.
So Ron, your team is going to be removing all of this mold on the underside of the roof. How are you going to do it?
Well, we're going to blast it off with this gun.
This gun, this looks like a pressure washer gun. So water or sand?
Actually, dry ice.
Dry ice, how's that work?
Well, we use pelletized dry ice. It's about 110 degrees below zero, so I got to wear a glove to touch it. Comes out of the gun at such a high speed, and then it explodes into a vapor. That energy blows the mold right off the sheathing.
Wow, is it messy?
Not really, it's pretty clean, but it does create some dust.
I see, well that's why you got a lot of plastic down, but also that explains the negative air machine here. This negative air machine probably will take that dust through the filter into the HEPA filter, cleaning the air so when it exits the building through the gable vent, it will exit as clean air.
Right.
Seems like a pretty complicated process. How long does it take?
Well, a lot of our time is spent just preparing the area here to make sure that we don't let the mold dust back down into the living space. Once that's done and we're all ready to go, it moves right along.
All right, well, we'll get out of here so you can get started.
Those dry ice pellets are coming out of that nozzle at about 1,000 miles an hour, so there's a lot of energy up there.
1,000 miles an hour?
Right, there's so much energy between the impact and the thermal shock, it profiles the wood just a little bit. When those pellets turn into vapor, they go right from a pellet to a vapor, that energy actually blows the mold right off of the sheathing.
Well, I'm surprised because I actually thought that we would see a lot more dust, but I don't see much dust.
No, really, all you're seeing is the mold spores that are being blown off. You see a little vapor, that's the carbon dioxide getting put back into the air.
Most of the mold gets sucked up by the air cleaner and is trapped by the filter. The rest of the mold falls on the plastic on the floor and is cleaned up at the end.
Right, when you see the bright wood looking back at you, there's no more black, there's no more shadowing. The mold is gone, the roots are gone.
It looks pretty good to me, almost new.
Right.
And that won't come back again.
No. That won't come back as long as they fix the ventilation issues and the insulation issues so that there's no more moisture buildup up there.
Boy, Ron, that ice blasting really cleaned the mold off the underside of that plywood right here in this section. It almost looks brand new.
Yeah, it does a really great job. The mold's all gone. We have a little more blasting to do, but when we're all finished with that, we're going to coat everything up here just to be sure. With a mold inhibiting coating, the rafters, the sheathing. In case there are any roots or any mold that we might have missed, it won't grow back again.
Hi, I'm Michael McKillican. Unfortunately, people do find mold after they list their home and then the inspectors come back and it ends up being a negotiation tool. So get your house checked for mold before you list.